Welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. My name is Brick Everson, and I'm here with Tim Oakley and Sigfried Seeliger. You may know them from their work on such films as, we mentioned, Indiana Jones and The Crystal Skull, I think, earlier, or I intended to, so we'll pretend that those are the same thing. And you've worked on
Twilight.
Oprah.
Yeah.
Wait, did you say Oprah?
Yeah.
Really?
I did that Pregnant Man episode
in Bend, Oregon.
With
the He-Man. I forgot
that guy existed until just this very moment.
That was really awkward.
I think he's pregnant again, isn't he?
Yeah.
So what
yeah.
did you, were you, did you light the pregnant man?
Yeah, everything like
sounds
camera
like a crude
for that. Yeah, and it was like, it was really kind of, yeah, camera and sound, and it was, yeah, it was really kind of awkward, and as we had to be super secret, we, like, wrote little confidentiality agreements, and, you know, it was actually more than when I worked with FBI or Homeland Security. It was like more like little secret agreements and stuff like that. So
wait, well, you can't just say when I worked with Homeland Security and then just sort of move on, like gloss over that. Is that a thing you actually did?
I don't think I can talk about that.
Okay. Well,
no, it was like there's you work with them for like video purposes for like if. Say they have a testing for a dirty bomb that goes off, then you like video
that. That happened a couple. So that was a couple years ago when they did. I don't remember where it happened, but it was somewhere near here. It wasn't a bridge, was it? How was it?
Yeah, it was like a. It was a.
To whatever extent you can reveal the information.
Yes, and so it
bridge
was
a.
It was it was a supposedly a bridge, and it would go off, and then you played a kind of like a news team, and it was almost like a game, and you try to like try to push the limits of
to
what
get the
police,
information, and they're trying to keep you from getting the information.
But also filling out the information to other government, so like other parts of the government in the state, so they would have it on a news screen, this like news channel, and we would also. The weirdest part was actually the governor, Kulongowski, who I've worked with many times. He supposedly got sick from this bomb in this case scenario.
This is a fictitious,
very fictitious thing. It was a test, and then they reverted back to another. The head of the Senate to take over.
Like the chain of command.
Yeah, and actually he did for a little bit in the test. And so it was very strange.
Bizarre. This entire interview, which I mean this in the best possible way, this entire show is like a Wikipedia article where every single word is a hyperlink, and I just want to open it as a separate tab in my browser.
You should see what's going on in our heads half the time.
No, thanks. I mean, really, maybe more so for you. I'm going to pass
but
on that.
But it's great with our industry. It's like we get to work with things that you would never think possible.
I mean, that's the thing. Like when
it's
you,
really fun.
You know, when you wake up and you have no idea that the FBI or Orson Welles or whatever.
Or
you know,
a pregnant, hairy guy who, who's
or that,
yeah,
sure,
man.
That they're in your future that day.
There was kind of like dealing with the FBI and stuff. When you've been to my office, and I have these two cameras, these bulb cameras that are up there that are on all the time because... ever since dealing with the U.S. government in Salem, they just said, now you're part of us. You're part of the mob. You can never get out. And we have to videotape you in your office to make sure that, A, when you are working on certain like confidentiality items, whether it be, kind of observing counterfeit bills and things of that sort for us, we have to videotape you all the time. So it's kind of weird to know that at any time I walk into the office or anybody who walks into that studio, they're being videotaped all the time.
It's even weirder if you've been in that office many times and didn't know you were being videotaped. Let's talk about
what were you
past.
Doing in the office?
That's not
just it's awkward.
It's private.
Think
awkward.
Chuck Berry.
Awkward. Okay.
What's the movie or the television show that made you want to start this as a career? What was the defining moment where you watched a film and you're like, that's a good job. I gotta work in that industry.
I brought it with me.
Is this another blown-up version of a body part of mine?
I saw this movie, and it was Citizen Kane, and that's the production script for that. And that is the film that said, I want to be in this industry.
And I always have, like, a copy of Citizen Kane with me.
Just ask.
Always.
Do you just carry this around in your bag?
Would you like to see others?
Do you carry the Grail in there, too?
Just,
like, in case I should need it later on?
I have the head from Raiders right here.
So you saw Citizen Kane, and you just said... You just said,
I've
got to
be a part of that. Actually,
do.
What the ending of Citizen Kane, where it just said the end in that beautiful script and the castles in the background, that I wanted to be the person who did that. I wanted to be the credit guy. I just wanted, because I was into typography at an early age, and I just loved to type. And type led to student films in New York and Santa Rosa and Hawaii, and one thing led to another, and I just got into films. But that's the defining moment for me.
Let me just, I'm not supposed to do this sort of thing, but Colin, what segment is this? Is this two or five, or this is the third segment? That doesn't even seem possible. It's like I've fallen into some sort of a flux wormhole.
Is this, aren't we doing a two-parter?
It's a rift. I think you're reading my mind. Get out of my head. We'll return after this on Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV, and we'll
drink more.
We'll see where that takes us.
Yeah.
Stay right there.